The n plus 1 rule allows us to predict how many peaks we would expect to see for a signal in an NMR spectrum. So if we think about the signal for one proton, if that proton has n neighboring protons, we would expect to see n plus 1 peaks on the NMR spectrum. The n plus 1 rule only applies when the neighboring protons are chemically equivalent to each other. So in the last video, we looked at this molecule, and we focused in on this proton right here in red, and we said that this signal right here was due to the proton in red, and we also talked about this proton right here in blue, and this signal is due to the proton in blue. Let's look at the proton in red. All right, so let's see how many neighboring protons we have. So if you think about this carbon, right, and you think about the carbon next door, so this carbon right here, so this proton is a neighbor, right? So we have one neighbor so far. We go over here to this carbon, this next door carbon here. There are no protons on that carbon. So we have a total of only one neighboring proton for the red proton. So one neighboring proton, so n is equal to 1. So we're going to see 1 plus 1 peaks. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. We expect to see 2 peaks for the signal for the red proton, right? So here's the signal, and we see our 2 peaks. So this is called a doublet. So the signal for the red proton is split into 2 peaks because of the presence of the neighboring blue proton. All right, let's do the same thing for the blue proton, right? So we think about the signal for the blue proton. How many neighboring protons do we have? Well, if we go to the carbon next door, so this carbon, there are no protons on this carbon. And on this carbon, we of course have one proton, so only one neighbor. So n is equal to 1. We're going to see n plus 1 peaks. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. We expect to see 2 peaks. So we go over here to the signal for the blue proton, and we see our 2 peaks. So we get a doublet. One neighbor gives us a doublet here. What about the protons over here, these protons in magenta, right? So how many neighbors do we have for those protons? Go over here to the oxygen, right? No protons on that, no neighbors. So n is equal to 0. N plus 1 peaks, so 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. We'd expect only one peak for the signal for these three equivalent protons. And of course, this is the signal, right? Only one peak, and we call this a singlet. All right, let's do another one. So we also saw this molecule in the last video, right? So over here, and let's look at our protons. We expect one signal for the blue proton, and we would expect one signal for these red protons here. Let's think about the red protons first. So how many neighboring protons do we have? All right, so we go to the carbon next door, and then we have one proton, so one neighbor. So n is equal to 1, so we expect 1 plus 1 peaks, so we expect 2 peaks. So the signal for the red protons needs to have 2 peaks. So this one right here, so there's one peak, and there's the second peak, so we get a doublet. All right, what about the signal for the blue proton, right? So we get a signal for the blue proton. How many neighboring protons do we have? So we go to the carbon next door, and we have 1, 2 neighbors. So for the blue proton, we have 2 neighbors. N is equal to 2. Expect n plus 1 peaks. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So 3 peaks for this signal. So this signal is right here, and we get 1, 2, and 3. 3 peaks, which is called a triplet. All right, let's go to the next one. So let's look at this one right here. Okay, so we have bromoethane. So let's first draw in the protons. So on this carbon, we have 2 protons. And on this carbon, we have 3 protons. All right, so let's start with the signal. Let's start for the signal for these protons right here. So these are equivalent. We'd expect one signal for those protons. How many neighbors do those protons have? All right, we go to the carbon next door, and we have 1, 2. We have 2 neighbors. So n is equal to 2. We would expect n plus 1 peaks. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. We would expect a triplet for this signal. And here is our triplet, right? 1, 2, and 3 peaks for that one. Next, let's think about the signal for these two protons, right? So how many neighbors do those two protons have? So we go to the carbon next door, 1, 2, 3 neighbors. So N is equal to 3, so 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. We would expect a signal with 4 peaks for the protons in blue. And here's our signal with 4 peaks, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we call this a quartet. Right, so four peaks, we call it a quartet. Let's do another one. Let's look at this molecule right here. All right, and let's first draw in the protons. All right, so on this carbon, there are 3 protons. So here are the 3 protons. On this carbon, there are 3 protons. And on this carbon, there would only be 1 proton. So here's this one. Let's think about how many signals we would expect to see. So not thinking about the N plus 1 rule or spin splitting here. So a signal for these protons are in the same environment as these protons. So that's one signal for those. And then we would expect a signal for this proton right here in a different environment. All right, let's think about the signal for the red protons first. How many neighboring protons do the red protons have? We go to the carbon next door, right? And this is the carbon next door for both of those red protons. And there's one neighbor, right? So one neighbor, N is equal to 1. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. We would expect a doublet for this signal. And so that must be this, right? So this is kind of like a zoom in, and it's not the exact same drawing. I hand drew all this stuff, so it's not exactly perfect. But you can see there are two peaks here, two peaks. So this is a zoom in. This is supposed to represent a zoom in of those two peaks there. So that's that signal. What about the blue proton, right? So how many neighbors does the blue proton have? Right, so we look at this carbon and we look at the next door carbon. So this is the carbon next door, 1, 2, 3. This carbon is also next door to this carbon. So 1, 2, 3, so a total of 6. So N is equal to 6, so expect N plus 1 peaks. So 6 plus 1 is equal to 7, right? So we'd expect 7 peaks, called a septet. Let me go ahead and rewrite that here. So let me go ahead and write septet here, and let's look at this signal. It must be this right here, right? And this is pretty hard to draw, and once again, this is a blow-up of what you're looking at. So we'd expect 7 peaks, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So that's the idea of the N plus 1 rule. And let's talk a little bit more about spin splitting and when to expect a signal. So if you have chemically equivalent protons, they don't show spin splitting, right? So if I look at these two protons right here, these two protons are in the same environment as these two protons, right? Think about symmetry. So we'd expect only one signal. We would expect only one signal on the NMR spectrum. And these protons are not going to split these protons, even though they're next door, because they're chemically equivalent to each other. So chemically equivalent protons do not show spin splitting. All right, let's look at these examples right here. So what we've been talking about is next door protons, right? So this proton and this proton, right, will split each other's signal if they're in different environments. So splitting is observed, right? We're talking about these next door protons here. But if you have this situation, so let's just once again make this the red proton and make this the blue proton, right? There's an extra carbon in between. So splitting is generally not observed for this situation. So the red and the blue protons won't split each other generally. Again, there are exceptions. But for simple NMR spectra, you really have to think about the situation on the left here. So these protons are too far apart for them to feel any effect. And then finally, it is possible to have splitting from protons on the same carbon. So if these are in different environments, right? So if this proton is in a different environment from this proton, it's possible for splitting to be observed. And we'll talk more about that in the next video.